All right, Hometown 7 and Philly from Philly's very own. Here's your ESM6 menu settings for vlogging. One-handed operation, sensible use of auto modes, and saving on battery life as much as possible. Let's do it. So start by putting the camera into movie mode, then hit up the quick menu via clicking the button in the middle of the click wheel and make sure you're in movie auto exposure mode. Now the rec mode, I just turn to movie auto exposure mode. Image quality doesn't concern me. Shooting information display. Screen info toggle settings. Now this is your basic screen giving you all the necessary information while recording, but this one right here you only need when studio shooting this camera, but not when vlogging. This one is great if you want to set the framing right and have nothing else bother you on screen. And this one is just a good overview of all the settings you set up, including audio levels. Grid display, I prefer the 3x3 because everything else, in my opinion, just crowds up the screen. Histogram doesn't concern me. Reverse display on, because otherwise, if you flip the screen up into selfie mode, the image doesn't reverse and you're looking at yourself bottom to top. Image review, I turn it off because I like to use shutter autofocus, which you do by half pressing the shutter button, but every once in a while I press it in completely and I take a picture, which is not what I want to do in the first place, so I also don't want to look at the picture afterwards. That's why I turn image review off. Quick setting menu layout. Now autofocus method is good, image quality we don't need. Movie rec size, of course we need. Drive mode, unnecessary. Self timer remote control, unnecessary. White balance is good, picture style is good. Auto lighting optimizer, we don't need. Hit end, confirm, and now we got a vlogging quick menu with nothing unnecessary there. Autofocus method, of course, face tracking and tracking. Focus mode, autofocus. Manual focus peaking settings. Peaking, turned on. It's a very useful feature when you're using manual focus. Level, high or low, just defines how bright the peaking color is. I like high. Color, red does best for most occasions. Sometimes at nighttime, yellow or blue work a little better. Image stabilization settings, continuous, digital IS, I turn off. So this way I get only optical image stabilization from the lens, so the camera doesn't crop into my image to give me smoother video. Auto level is always disabled because if you enable it, you allow the camera to use digital image stabilization whenever it sees fit, cropping into the image whenever it sees fit. I never have that enabled because I always make it a conscious decision to use digital image stabilization or not. Lens aberration correction. If you're using native Canon lenses and are already running the latest firmware, the camera has all the data it needs. Just keep these settings enabled so the camera can automatically correct for the shortcomings of the lens. Highlight tone priority. When vlogging at night, I usually leave it off. If I'm vlogging during the day, I turn this to D+, so the camera, when exposing, favors the highlights instead of the shadows. White balance, I leave in auto mode. You're probably never gonna touch custom white balance when vlogging. I never touch white balance correction. Picture style, I do touch. If I don't wanna do post-production, I will simply hit up a user-defined profile, select the standard picture profile and alter it like this. Overall sharpness 6, fineness and threshold 2. And these seem to give me the best overall sharpness without sacrificing detail. Now I always opt for decontrasting a little, because with cameras that don't come with a very high dynamic range as it is, if contrasts are too high, images can look comicky very quickly. And I always go for a more naturalistic look. Now usually I like to desaturate a little as well. Again, this gives me a more naturalistic look, but if you like your images to be more vivid, you could also leave this at 0 or maybe even go to a 2. Now with color tone, you also adjust skin tone, and since I'm pretty pale, I benefit from a more yellowish skin tone. If you got dark skin, you can leave this at 0, you're always gonna look beautiful. But if you're pale like me, probably you're gonna benefit from a more yellowish skin tone as well. Now if I do wanna do the full post-production thing, I will hit up the second user-defined profile, again choose standard picture style and alter it like this. Desharpen completely, decontrast completely, desaturate completely, and again, color tone I set to 2. For one, this gives me the flattest possible image right out of the camera, and also, I can now take care of sharpness, contrast, and saturation to exactly the extent that I see fit in post-production. Drive mode and self-timer doesn't concern me. Movie rec size, now since I'm shooting PAL, this is between 25 frames per second and 50. If you were to shoot NTSC, this would be 30 frames per second and 60 frames per second respectively. I'm gonna choose 50. Do I need fluid motion? I will export to 50. Do I not need it? I will simply export to 25 frames per second. Sound recording. If I'm using internal audio, I will leave this on auto. But if I'm using external audio, like I do with the EOS M6, I manually level. And I set this so pretty much the mic levels to minus 12 decibels if I were to speak directly into it from about selfie distance away. Wind filter attenuator, I turn that off because I'd much rather have the dead cat take care of wind noise instead of the attenuator leveling down overall volume and leveling down my voice with it. Movie servo AF, of course, always on. Autofocus with shutter button during video. This is pretty useful because sometimes a combination of shutter autofocus, which means half pressing the shutter to force the camera to autofocus, and one point autofocus is the only way to get focus at all. Now, auto slow shutter can be a useful setting. It simply means that when this is turned on, if you're shooting 50 frames per second, usually you wouldn't go below a shutter speed of 1/50th of a second. Still, if this is enabled, the camera will go below that to the slowest shutter speed possible, which in my case, shooting PAL, would be 1/25th of a second, and in your case, if you're shooting NTSC, would be 1/30th. So the camera automatically detects when you're in a low light situation and chooses a slower shutter speed, which will kill the fluid motion effect of your 50 frames per second, but get you a brighter image. I still like to turn this off because if I am in a low light situation, I want to consciously decide between 50 frames per second and 25. Now create folder. Of course, if you're vlogging, you want it daily. File numbering, it's totally up to you. Video systems, this is where it can change between PAL and NTSC. Electronic level, just set the camera up level with no pitch once. Do it once for horizontal, do it once for vertical, and that's it. Eco mode is turned off because I want to set all the power saving options myself. Display off after 15 seconds, auto power down after 30 seconds. Whatever saves on battery life is well appreciated. Display brightness, now 2 is usually fine for most situations. 3, 4 or 5 you only need when you're shooting outside in bright sunlight and you can't see anything on the screen. The rest doesn't concern me. I hate it when cameras beep. Operation volume, off. The more silent the camera is for vlogging, the better. Hints and tips, off. Mode icon size, doesn't concern me. Touch operation, sensitive. Sensor cleaning, now auto cleaning is always enabled, so whenever you turn the camera off, it quickly cleans the sensor, but every once in a while, I hit clean now because it's a more thorough type of sensor cleaning. None of this concerns me right now. Now custom functions, others, custom controls. Shutter button and this button right here. I leave it force autofocus by half pressing the shutter button and lock and unlock exposure. The dials, now this dial is shutter speed and this dial is the f-stop. It's a standard I never touch. Now this rare dial right here, you can set the function for different modes, and the only one that makes sense is manual movie mode. And in manual movie mode, I like to set it to the ISO. So when you're in manual movie mode, like right now, this is the shutter speed, this is the f-stop, and this is the ISO. Now the other buttons, now this custom function button up here gets assigned the record function. So now instead of using the button back here, you can simply use the custom function button to start and stop your recording. Now to the ISO button, I assign the picture style selection. Now to the trash can button or clicking down on a click wheel, I assign the autofocus method selection. And to this button or clicking right on the click wheel, I guess you could assign the white balance or just leave it unassigned. And basically, except for the video mode, you can set up everything you need to set up via the click wheel. Now release shutter without lens, don't care. Reject lens on power off, don't care either. Now I would like to add a my menu tab. I would like to set it up and select a couple of items. Rec mode, image stabilization settings, highlight tone priority, picture style, movie rec size, and sound recording. And this way I have all the settings I look for in the menus like 90 to 95% of the time within one menu. And that's how I set up the M6 for vlogging.
So if you found this video helpful, please make sure to leave a thumbs up, it'd be greatly appreciated. Any kind of comment or feedback is welcome, and I'll try to answer as quickly as possible. In any case, as always, thank you so much for your time, thank you for watching, and hopefully see you again soon.